Hi everyone, I have another video on the basics of using syringes such as this one. Why? Because people keep asking me about it. Today I'm going to be talking about reusing syringes because unlike with the pen, which is meant for reusability, you can safely reuse the needle on this multiple times if you want to. Now don't use it too much because I actually had a story of a friend one time who he reused his needle on one of these pens so much that the needle actually broke off inside of him. He needed surgery to get removed. So don't use it too much, but you don't have a lot of risk with reusing the pen needle a couple of times, right? Because it's not going to make the insulin go bad or anything. But with syringes, well, there actually is a bit of a risk with reusing them. A lot of people do anyways, but there is a risk. Why? Because it turns out that old insulin left in a syringe can actually contaminate and what is known as polymerize insulin that is back in the vial. Because what happens is the vials, right, these are glass. I know I have plastic around it that's to protect it, but the vial itself is glass. It is non-reactive. It's not going to react to the insulin at all. That's why they use glass. The other hand, these syringes are made of plastic. They're made of silicone specifically. They have a silicone lining inside of them. And over time, this silicone lining can actually slightly interact with the insulin. Now, it's not going to cause it to become harmful or anything, but it will cause it to become less effective. And it will actually sort of polymerize the insulin proteins and sort of change their structure a little bit. And if this insulin sitting in the syringe and in the needle here sits and sits in there for hours or days or whatever it is, and then you inject it back into a clean insulin vial, that same old polymerized insulin is going to cause more polymerization in the vial. It's going to sort of act like a seed where it ends up clouding up your insulin and making it less effective. So that's why it's not a good idea to reuse syringes, because you risk, if let's say I pull some insulin out of here, right? I pull some insulin out and then I use it, you know, I use the insulin, and then later on I pull some more insulin out, I push it back in to get rid of the bubbles and I push it back out. Well, me pushing that insulin back in also pushes the old insulin back into the vial, and that can start that polymerization process. Now, it's not bad if it's done just a couple of times, but if you keep reusing the syringes over and over, that's going to add up, and it's going to make your insulin eventually go bad. And what will happen is you'll one day notice that your insulin's very cloudy and that it isn't working as effective as it should. You're taking a ton more insulin than you think you should, you know, it's sort of acting like water, and you're wondering why this is. Am I more insulin resistant? Why the blood sugar high all the time? Well, it's probably because you reuse your syringes and now your insulin is just not as effective. And if that's the case, you want to throw it out and get some new insulin. Obviously, insulin could be expensive. Our insulin's not that expensive, fortunately, but other insulins can be. You don't want to throw your insulin, so it's best not to risk it. Now, how do we avoid the risk while reusing syringes? Because the thing is, if you use one syringe for every correction, for every bolus, basal, whatever, that can get pretty wasteful, right? You can end up using a lot of syringes. Fortunately, they're pretty cheap. You can get them pretty cheap at Walmart, $100. Or you can get a pack of 100 for like $12. So it's not too expensive to not reuse syringes, but it is a lot of waste, and I don't like to waste. I have a few tricks up my sleeves to do that. Now, the most simple and obvious thing is, of course, you draw up your insulin, right? You draw up your insulin without pushing any insulin back in. That's one thing you can do. Now, I don't like doing this because I have a bad habit of whenever I see bubbles, I push it back into the vial instantly without even thinking about it. And of course, if you have that habit too, then you're going to end up putting old insulin back into your vial without even realizing it. Of course, if you find bubbles in it, what you could do is you could pull your vial out and push the insulin out and the bubbles that way and then try again. But you might end up with more bubbles, so it's not exactly an easy process, and you're going to waste a little bit of insulin doing it. Alternatively, you can use a tool, like one of the tools I have in my videos. I'll link them below. I have one to where I fill up about 5 units in the syringe, and then I have a tool that makes it so I can take little micro doses of half unit, quarter of unit, up to 5 units, and I just use that up until the 5 units are done, and then I throw that syringe away and I use a new one. So I end up getting a lot of different doses because my doses are usually very small for corrections without having to put it back in the vial. So that's one thing you can do. Another option would be to work with the timing of it. Because I said earlier that this polymerization takes a few hours or a few days. If the insulin in this syringe is only in there for like an hour or less, then your risk of polymerization is very low because it takes a little bit of time to interact with the insulin here. So for example, let's say you split your bolus or you split your basal. You know you're going to get 2 doses and you know exactly what those 2 doses are going to be. Well, in that case, right, what you want to do is you pull out the dose for your first part, you'd inject that, and then right after you're done injecting it, you pull out that second dose, you put the cap back on. If you can fit it, it only goes up to about 1.5 units for the cap. If it's any higher, then don't use this cap, but if you can fit the cap on here, put the cap on so that way it's secure, and there you go. You can use this syringe 2 times at least instead of 1 without risking the new insulin here. And that will save you at least half of your syringes, right? That's better than nothing. That's what I do personally for my basal and my bolus. I split both. I take 1 syringe per day for the basal by doing exactly that technique, and I take 1 syringe per meal by doing that technique as well. For the corrections, I use the tool I talked about. Again, I'll link that video in the description. And I actually have another tool I use where I use a Humalog Lily pen. Here, let me actually get it for you. It's right in the fridge here. I use this Humalog Quick Pen that I've modified to put a syringe in. And that way, just like with the other tool, I fill the syringe up to about 6 units. I dial this all the way back. And I use the plunger in here to push insulin through here for microdosing up to 1/10 of a unit until it's down to 0. And then I throw the syringe away and use a new one. My corrections are normally about half unit, quarter of unit, maybe up to a unit or 2. So being able to use something like this or like my other tool that goes up to 5 units allows me to use a syringe multiple times for my corrections without having to put it back in the vial, without having that risk. Now, of course, there are other risks not associated with old insulin that can happen if you reuse your syringes too much, and you certainly don't want to reuse it with other people, right? That's how you spread diseases and such. And of course, it's like I said before, the needle can wear down, and if you're really not careful, it can break off. So you want to be careful if you want to reuse your syringes, but that's how it's done. In general, it's not, there is a risk. Some people do it anyway. Last thing I'll say, if you're wondering, if you have reused the syringes, if you have pushed old insulin back into the vial, how do you know when the insulin goes bad? Well, you just know from how it affects you. If you notice that your insulin's not working like it should, you need more insulin than you used to, don't assume insulin resistance if you've been reusing your syringes. Assume, check your vial and see if it's cloudy, and if it is, well, you might just need new insulin. Never take that doubt out of your mind. It could just be you need new insulin. So if you're having that issue, try that. Otherwise, if your insulin's working the same, even if it looks a little cloudy, then no big deal. If it works, it works, right? You go by how it is affecting you. That's all, everyone. Keep taking that type 1. If you have any more questions about using syringes, let me know in the comments below. I love to explain more about them because I love using them. I think they're great for precision, for quickness, for convenience, and I've gone over this in a couple other videos, and I think they're ideal for managing diabetes with a low-carb diet. But if you're confused about anything, I'd love to know below so you can get started using syringes too. Until next time, keep taming that type 1, everyone. Syringes over pens. Y'all have a good day.